Welcome to the Coast to Coast podcast, brought to you by Play Picks and the Lines, coming to you from the West Coast. Josh Lander, joined as always by Nate Weitzer, holding it down on the East Coast. Another beautiful article up on playpicks.com for you guys. Some best bets, a few props in there you might like, which is what we're about to get into here. This is our daily player props video for you guys. Make sure you also do check out that Wizards Raptors video that we have out there for you, as well as the Warriors hosting the Hornets tonight. But as always, if you do still need a FanDuel or DraftKings account, head to fdpicks.com or dkpicks.com and find those listings in your area, such as what we've got for tonight. Nate, let's jump into Wednesday night slate.
Yeah, I've been fishing for this one since last week, right? The James Harden props. I mean, most of them have hit in terms of his combined PRA. Certainly, he's got 47 points, 18 boards, 20 assists in his last two games. And those came in pretty easy wins over the Pistons and Pacers. So I'm expecting a lot more playing time and a lot more output from him tonight with the Hawks in town. I think the Hawks beat the Nets 2 out of 3 last year. Real feisty team, obviously. This is kind of a playoff caliber matchup. And despite Atlanta's good overall numbers, no answer for James Harden, who's averaging 40.8 points, 7.3 rebounds, and 10.8 assists in his last four against them. The Nets are on an extra day of rest compared to Atlanta. And they're at home, of course, where they averaged 118 points per game and 27 assists per game, league high. Last season, this season, the offense has not been up to snuff. Sure, they still haven't gone over in any game, and the total sits at 220 here. I think it might change tonight, but I'm not recommending we bet on that, the way the Hawks can play defense. I am just saying that Harden and Durant at home will do their thing. We'll keep the Nets competitive, probably in front. And I think Harden's going to sniff around at that triple-double as he is wont to do. And I mean, it's like plus 800 at 830, I believe, at FanDuel for him to get a triple double in a win. If you wanted to go fishing for that one, I would stick with the most conservative bet, 36.5 points, rebounds, assists for Harden. As I mentioned, he's been over that in each of his last two games, and good all around production from him. If you do feel like he's going to be continue to be aggressive, which he has in his last two games, he has seven threes and scoring plenty. For him to get 25 plus points in a win is plus 370, a lot better chance of that than the triple double, I believe. And just the straight player points prop is 20.5. I think he has a good chance for that one as well.
Yeah, the points are scaring me with Harden this year. You know, the only person whose points I feel comfortable taking right now is Kevin Durant. It almost seems like they could really use a third scorer who's like a really crafty scoring guard of some kind, but they don't really have one in tow right now. So it's just Harden and Durant. But, you know, the points, rebounds, and assists is definitely what stands out for me. I love looking at how players play against specific teams as well. Shout out StatMuse.com, which continues to do a great job in partnership with the NBA at being able to help us with specifics like that really easily. And what you brought up in terms of how he plays against Atlanta, specifically his last four, insane stats, right? In terms of how averaging 40 a game, 7 boards, and the 11 assists. It's really about the boards and assists for him that make me feel good about taking a prop for Harden right now. As I don't think he's looking for his scoring. He has in the last couple, to your point, but it's still to the tune of about 23.5 points a game, which would get you over that player point total 20.5, which is what I feel good about. If you want to, you know, spice up your odds, as you mentioned, the plus 370 for those 25 points in a win is a little bit more obviously dangerous, but definitely the 20.5 or the PRA is where I would stick with Harden tonight. And then moving on to DeMar DeRozan on the Bulls, taking on the Philly 76ers, who we all know are very good at pace, or as defense rather. They're also specifically very, very good at that at home. But really, you know, DeRozan, what he does is really the only thing that Philly doesn't really defend well, which is that mid-range jumper that we talk about with him. And really, he's become more of a playmaker this year. I think he's added that to his game in the last few years when he was really expected to be something more for the Spurs than just a 20 a night scorer. He started to put together a little bit more of a playmaking package, which, you know, makes me feel a little bit better about his just the amount that he has the ball in his hands, right? The usage rate that he's seen on the Bulls team is really, really good, considering you also have Lonzo Ball and Zach LaVine back there who can handle the ball just as well. But he's the one with the ball in his hands. And like we said, making those mid-range jumpers, which is something that he's doing really, really well. always. And Philly, that's the one area where they allow teams to score a little bit more is in those mid-range shots, as teams obviously are more likely to pull up rather than jump into Joel Embiid's big ass and try to score on him in the paint. So I think you'll continue to see that. Works out perfectly for DeMar. You can get him to get 21 and a half points at DraftKings. And it's plus 150. That's minus 120 on DraftKings. Over at FanDuel, it's actually plus 152 for him to get 25 plus tonight. I think we'll see a little bit more points. This is the number one and two offensive rated teams in the league this year. And so I think you'll continue to see some points for them. Philly's definitely hurt with on defense by a lack of Ben Simmons as well. So, you know, it all really, to me, points towards a big night for DeMar DeRozan. Rosen specifically in a game that's tailor made for his style of play.
Yeah, this game is tailor made because Philly is dead last in pace at home, and Chicago, they just want to push it right with Lonzo and Caruso. But when that doesn't work, it's very much here you go, DeMar, do some half court stuff, and yep. That's why they lead the league in mid range scoring on the road, getting 15% of their points of that, which is huge in today's NBA at 15%. And DeMar has been slightly better on the road last year. He's playing slightly more minutes this year. And just recently, he's really been doing that thing where they give him the ball and he says, I got you guys. He's scoring 28.8 points per game on ridiculous 53-46, 98% splits with a 31% usage rate in his last four against playoff caliber teams. He scored 28 points per game his last three trips to Philly. This is a great matchup for him. I feel very confident about at least 22 points from DeMar. I would bet heavily on that and probably will. I'm taking the under on our guy Paul George, though, out in Minnesota. The Wolves have been very underrated on defense. Really, since the end of last season, we've talked about once they finally got their big three, their young big three, together, they were a good team on both sides of the ball, and that's carried over this year. They're actually third in three-point defense, allowing below 30% and allowing the seventh fewest makes from deep. Paul George is really feast or famine depending on how many threes he's going to hit. He's gone way below his prop of 28.5 points twice this year because he went 0 for 8 and 2 for 10 from deep in those games and has not had a lot of success against the Wolves. Even in recent years, just 20.8 points per game, despite chucking at a 33% usage rate in those games. They have some really athletic wing defenders, right? Josh Okogie, one of the McDaniels. And so if you don't think Paul George is going to get to 28 points, the question is, who's going to be the leading scorer in this game? And Karl Anthony Towns at plus 220 is definitely where I would look there. You could also take Anthony Edwards at plus 300, but I think Cat, who has a 28.5% usage rate at home this year, a little too quick for Ivica Zubac if they're going to – Ivica, I believe, friend of the show. If they're going to put him on there and the Clippers not as much depth behind him in terms of options to try to stop Cat.
Yeah, and Cat at plus 200 feels great. Anthony Edwards, really nice too. He's been their scorer for the most part of the season going off at different times. But at the same time, when you look at what the Clippers have, they've got pretty good wing defenders. Paul George, we know what he can do on defense, and even Batum still has some crafty ways about him on the wing. So I would feel a lot better about Towns going up against Ivica Zubac and being the top point scorer in this one as well. And do like the Paul George unders. These are two teams that are going under a ton this season, all but one game for each of them that they've gone under in their points total. And it's really, for me specifically for Minnesota, it is because of their defense. When you look at how many points they've given up this season, it's incredible. I mean, they gave up 115 in a weird loss to the Magic. But other than that, they haven't given up more than 108 and have a couple games under 100, even 90 points that they've given up this year. I still have the Clippers matchup recently where they scored four against the Blazers. They had 41 points as a team through three and a half quarters. So there was 6 minutes left in the third. They have 41 points. And it's really because if you look at everybody outside of Paul George, nobody can do anything. Like nobody. It was unbelievable that nobody had 10 points outside of Paul George in that game for the Clippers. And it's just a sputtering offense that how far they have fallen since the Kawhi Paul George arrival in LA there. So one more player prop for you that I have here is DJM, DeJounte Murray, on the San Antonio Spurs, putting up big, big numbers. If you haven't seen what he's doing so far this season, check it out. It's time we start talking about his about 18 points a game, about 8 boards, 8 assists as well, including 2 steals. And so he's just tearing up the court on both ends of it. But really, I think you can still get some value. He's another guy similar to Harden where I'm scared to just take the straight points because he does see himself as a facilitator and someone that needs to run the offense and not a very, very quick or fast paced offense at that as well with the Spurs. I do think that this is a moment in time for DeJounte to also get those rebounds and assists, which he's done really, really well, especially against Dallas, who they're playing tonight on the second leg of that back-to-back after getting beat up by Miami at home last night. We've got San Antonio coming in with DeJounte Murray on in his last two versus Dallas, 24 points a game in those two, almost 8 boards and almost 7 assists as well in both of those games. And really, the Mavs on the second leg of a back-to-back have proven that they're not very good on defense. They're a little bit tired. They allow 110 points per game last year on the second leg of that back-to-back, about 44 and a half rebounds per game as well. So obviously that takes its toll on them. And Murray's got the ball in his hands a ton this year. His usage rate, it continues to go up. It's about 22.5% this year. He's rebounding the ball incredibly well, which is something that was sort of inconsistent for him last year, which is why he was a little bit more of a risk to bet on with his player props last year. Didn't know when he was going to show up, but he's bringing it every single night this year. And I feel really, really good. More so about his points, rebounds, and assists at 32.5, which is a slightly under what he's averaging for the season. So I'm definitely going to go for that against a Mavs team that should be pretty tired tonight.
Yeah, and you could probably just go with his straight rebounds assist prop in that instance. If you look at it, in 3 home games, he's averaging 9 boards and 10 assists. The shooting has not been there, to your point. He's got a huge dip in points per game at home, but you don't have to worry about that if you're just taking peripheral stats. And he's had no trouble. I mean, he has had no trouble scoring on Dallas in their last 2 meetings, 24 points per game, but also getting 7.5 rebounds, 6.5 assists. So I think you feel pretty confident about that. His rebounding rate is way up and his assist rate is up to 35.7% as he's really running that offense. Most of what the Spurs get is coming through DeJounte Murray, and the Mavericks are still looking for their identity under Jason Kidd.
Absolutely. Insert generic Jason Kidd tarnishing as we are wont to do on this show. That is all the time that we have for today. Please make sure to like and subscribe to that page as we're continuing to bring you things like these player props. And then also got a couple other videos out there today on tonight's Wednesday slate. The Raptors and Wizards we're looking at, as well as the Hornets and Warriors. Make sure to check those out. And until we see you guys again, happy betting.